43-mile-long Musconetcong River, or Muskie, winds its way through the northwest New Jersey village of Finesville, providing a high-quality, cold-water home to fish migrating through, and a good spot to drop a fishing line or kayak in the water. It took the right combination of planning, skills, funds, and people to return it to its natural state. Just over a year and a half ago, a 9-foot-high, 109-foot-long concrete dam stood here, part of a series of dams that continuously harnessed the Muskie at this spot for more than 250 years.
Most of these dams in this part of the state are obsolete. They have not been maintained, they're not up to current standards.
The dam played a valuable part in the history of Finesville for hundreds of years, but it hasn't been used in 40 or 50 years. So it's not really any economic benefit to the town and hasn't been for a long time. There's actually some safety issues too. Unfortunately, there's been a couple of drownings here.
It's a dangerous situation and removing the dam can certainly make this a safer river. I'll just be a very happy camper when this is out.
The actual dam removal, I think we figured a total of about 3 days. It's going well, and I think this will be another successful project.
Once that dam is removed, we'll go in and it'll be about a week's worth of work doing stream restoration, moving around larger stones to create that riffle pool and run system.
You know, dam removals are, I think, are the most rewarding type of restoration project to work on. And the reason why is because you get the biggest bang for your buck. You're really restoring natural processes to a river.
People need to understand why people want to do dam removals and why it's good for the river and why the changes that a dam removal brings start from the bottom of the river, literally, and, you know, really spread out to the entire ecosystem. By improving habitat for aquatic insects, we'll improve it then in the food source for fish, you know, frogs, turtles, and then the things that eat on those. So, so we'll improve habitat for things like heron, egret, eagle.
Restoring the ecological integrity will help recreational fishing. You know, Warren County recreational fishing is a multi-million-dollar business, brings in a lot of fishermen and money to the local economy.
People who can kayak down the stream don't have to pick up their kayak or canoe, go around the dam, now they can continue to kayak.
Area residents raised concerns during the planning process.
As a homeowner, being a few hundred yards behind the dam, close to the Delaware, there is a flooding issue. And the banking of the water from the dam caused us severe damage last year.
During Irene, the water came down, it came right in front of our house and people evacuated. And right after it was taken out, we had heavy rain again and no water came down the street. So we knew that it was gonna help with the flooding.
There was some concern expressed about dam removal's effect on local shallow groundwater wells. And we did some research and that research revealed that in over 20 projects in New Jersey, and 200 dam removal projects in Pennsylvania, there was only one documented incident where a shallow groundwater well was affected.
And we were concerned when they took it out that we wouldn't hear it. You know, our bedroom at night and you open the windows and you hear the falls and you get used to that after 13 years of being here. And we were concerned you wouldn't be able to hear that. But whatever they did, you can still hear the water flowing and it sounds nice.
The process is a lengthy one and a thorough one, but it's a good one that we, makes us think about every individual step, every individual natural resource concern, from sediment to water quality, surface water, groundwater, wildlife, plants, air quality, natural and historic resources.
The reason for the archaeological monitoring at Finesville Dam Project is to document any exposed timbers for the previous dams that were in place, the earliest of which is an 1807 dam that we just found the remains of.
The overall cost of projects like dam removal tend to be very expensive. The good news is that once it's done, once it's completed, if it's done well, it's a walk-away project. You walk away, you don't have to invest any more money in it.
We removed two dams in the town of Hackettstown about 3 or 4 years ago. Two dams down near the Delaware in Regalsville and Finesville. The next two dams upstream are owned by an old paper mill that no longer needs the dams, and they have contacted us and they're interested in removing the next two dams.
I love it. I think it looks great. My kids, you know, on a nice day, they're in there constantly with adult supervision, but they're always in the river, and I love it.